بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. All praises is due to Allah, whom we seek His help, we seek His forgiveness and mercy, blessings be upon our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Just few words, inshallah, before Adhan. First of all, alhamdulillah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed us. It's the biggest blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to made us Muslims. Because alhamdulillah, among the Muslims as well, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chooses us to be the one who only worship Him and His only oneness. Because the many Muslims, they are worshipping other things. You know? They are worshipping graves. They are worshipping their awliya, their righteous people. So alhamdulillah, look at the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He chooses us among all these creation to be Muslims. And among the Muslims to be the one who go on the path of Tawheed. Those who worship Allah alone, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Another blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is that He made us to witness the month of Ramadan. The month that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive His all slaves for no reason. Just because they witnessed Ramadan, they prayed in Ramadan, they fast for sake of Allah in Ramadan, and at the end, the reward is forgiveness from the hellfire. So I would like to just conclude with one hadith of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that in the day of judgment, all the prophets, all the righteous people, all the companion of the prophets, of Moses, of those who was following the Jesus, even the companion of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they will be on the day of judgment standing. And then they will see normal people, their status, their situation is higher than the Prophet themselves. They are so high in rank that the Prophet also cannot reach at that rank. So they are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who are these people? We are sure that they are not the prophets. The Prophet themselves, they are not sure that they are the prophets. So who are these people are that are in a high rank? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, those people are mutahabuna fi Allah. Those are the brothers who love each other for sake of Allah, for sake of Allah. So we are, alhamdulillah, in this place. Why we came for? Just for Islam and the brotherhood of Islam, and just that because we love each other for sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep this love in our heart for our brotherhood, for our brother Muslims and sisters all over the world. Because the reward of that even the companion of the prophets, even some of the prophets, they will feel the jealousy, the good jealousy. That how come these people reach at that status that we cannot reach? It's just because of the cleanliness of the heart. It's just because my heart is attached to my brother. It's just because I worry about my brother, who's a new Muslim or who's a Muslim and born. It's just because we are all Muslims. So alhamdulillah, it's a blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we are getting together here for sake of Allah. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have mercy on us because of this gathering. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before we leave this majlis, this gathering, that there will be an angel will call upon the heaven that قُومُوا مَغْفُورِينَ لَكُمْ قَدْ بُدِّلَتْ سَيِّئَاتُكُمْ حَسَنَاتِ. Get up, and before you leave, all your sins Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive and transform into the good deeds. So I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make all of us among these people. Wa sallallahu sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa jazakum Allah khair. And also, we have, mashallah, one of the best reciter in this masjid, in Masjid al-Jari, who came from Morocco. So mashallah, when he starts reciting, you know, you might not leave the prayer. So it's an opportunity, those who would like to join the Taraweeh in our masjid, inshallah. He's from Morocco, inshallah, in this masjid. And they are willing to also finish the Quran. And the way he recites, mashallah, it makes me to forget everything. So if you would like to also join, inshallah, you will feel the khushu, inshallah, in his, you know, prayer. Jazakallah. Yes, also, brother Jasim would like to say something.
Jazakallah khair. Thank you. Everybody, and thanks for Brother Muhammad for this speak. And you know, when he just speaking, I just something come to my head, and I would like to share it with my brothers. That you know, the big difference between the gathering, this kind of gathering, and any other gathering, you know, with the any normal people, that we in each gathering we make sure that we bless Allah Subhanahu wa Taala, and we praise Allah Subhanahu wa Taala. And you know, therefore, in each gathering, we would like to talk about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. to talk about God Almighty, and you know, to mention Allah Subhanahu wa Taala, and to mention our brotherhood, and to mention our relationship, and you know, to try to be more close to Allah Subhanahu wa Taala, and this is the beauty of the Muslim people, the right people, the Muslim with the beard, of the Muslim that Allah Subhanahu wa Taala, like Brother Muhammad said, please us with the Alhamdulillah, with the following the Sunnah. Following the way for the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So it's once we follow Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, we not just follow him by the outside, you know, by the beard and by the, you know, the no, from the outside and also from the inside, from trying to clean our heart, you know, to love each other for the sake of Allah, and it would be to think about Allah Subhanahu wa Taala and to think about the Islam and how to help the Islam, how to do something to give da'wah for the Muslim, and you will try to spend this life, you know, for pleasing Allah Subhanahu wa Taala. Last thing I will end it with it. I'm very, you know, when I came and I see, you know, the amount of the people, mashallah, too much people today. I was very happy from my side because, you know, last couple of months, once we meet every Friday, it used to be few people only. And you know, because the other, you know, they have their own, you know, circumstances, you know, such as we do have, you know, with this life. But you know, I would like, you know, everybody, you know, inshallah, after Ramadan or next inshallah meeting, we make sure, you know, everybody to attend, because you know, as much as the people came, as much as you know, the I don't know how to call it, you know the feeling, you know the feeling. I don't need to mention it. But you know, just make sure that once you come. You know, yes, you are one, but once this one add to the among the people, it's make the gathering, you know, much, you know, beauty. May Allah bless everyone, inshallah.
And also, there's a message from Abu Muhammad. It's not a message, he informed me, actually, that I would like to share with you. Abu Muhammad, the owner of the house, he is, inshallah, on Monday going for Umrah. But he was telling me that, wallahi, he loves you for sake of Allah. Wallahi, he was just telling me that I'm so happy to, you know, open my place for the brothers, and it's not about food and anything. Wallahi, he said, I'm just so pleased with the brothers. And the amount he loves you, wallahi, he was just telling me. And he said, wallahi, without anything, I will just go there to Mecca and I will make dua for everyone, you know, everyone. So as a compensation also, it's our duty to make dua for Abu Muhammad, inshallah, in our prayers and our dua. That may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless him. And bless his place, bless his house, bless his family, of giving us this opportunity and offering his house to us, inshallah. Jazakallah khair. Tafadhal, brother.
Just from what you were mentioning about the sins and forgiving, it reminded me, I had just read earlier from a message that I got from a brother concerning one of the forgotten sins of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. From Surah to Muhammad, the verse 19, when he, I don't know the Arabic, so, sorry, but from the English translation there, when he says, "And know la ilaha illallah, none has the right to be worshipped except Allah, and ask Allah to forgive you of your sins and forgive the sins of the believing men and the believing women." So this is a proof that we should ask Allah to forgive the believing males and the believing females, and those who ask forgiveness for the believing men and the believing females will get the reward of them, each one that is forgiven. You get a special reward from each one. So how many believing men and women we have, all about millions maybe, and you're asking forgiveness for them?
Billions, subhanAllah. And this is one of the things that reminded me, one of the sheikhs said, actually, you can have, you know, 1.3 or 1.6 billion reward in a second by saying, "Oh Allah, forgive Muslim men and Muslim women. Oh Allah, forgive, you know, believing men and believing women." Just by saying that, 1.6 billion reward in your account, you know. So just imagine in each salah, in each sujood, you know, if you just go by saying, you know, while in your sujood, you say three times, Subhana Rabbi al-Ala wa bihamdihi. After that, just say, "Oh Allah, forgive all the believing women and believing men." Just imagine in every salah and every sujood, if you say that, your each salah is 1.6 billion reward. So JazakAllah khair for reminding me.
Brother Abdul Karim, you know, Brother Abdul Karim, he say hello for everybody. You know, Brother Abdul Karim, the only from Britain. He came to Kuwait on the first day of Ramadan. but and he's doing an iktikaf in one of the masjid. And mashallah, you know, I would like to I want to bring him with me when I can. But you know, he has his own schedule, and he say, you know, I'm sorry I can't make it. You know, just say hi to everybody, because you know he's very busy with, you know, with the reading Quran with his schedule.
And, which masjid is
In Salwa. Yeah, in Salwa. But
do you know which masjid?
I don't know which, but so one of the brothers tell me the direction. I can't explain it.
Sure.
You know, one thing he reminded me with, you know, but by spending, you know, each minute in Ramadan, you know, the brother he told me he's doing in his iPad, he's doing, you know, in each time he do something ranking, then now reading Quran, and now, you know, reading some books now.
Schedule,
mashallah. So he say, you know, I just want to say hi for everybody. And
I just reminded me about checklist. There is a short movie of 3 minutes on YouTube about a real story. Did you saw that?
You brought it in.
I would like to share it with brothers. Okay, it's only 3 minutes. Brothers, just a brief. Do you want to?
No.
Just a brief story before we leave, before the Adhan. As the brother was saying about the scheduling and reading Quran and everything, there's a short movie on YouTube, one of the brothers sent me. There are two friends, they are walking at the beach, and they sit in the car. So one brother is driving, the other brother is having a paper with him and reading. So he said, why are you reading? You know, leave the paper, talk to me. I'm sitting next to you, why are you busy with the paper? Allahu Akbar. So he said, okay, fine. So he kept it on the car, on the top. And then he said, this brother was reading. He said, now we will witness Ramadan in 5 days. You know, so what's your schedule? So the driver, he said, well, Ramadan, nothing, hungry, nothing to do. What about you? He said, no, my Ramadan will be totally different. My Ramadan, it will be totally different. You know, I have my own schedule. So they are talking now. And after that, he said, the one who's driving, he said, okay, are you coming tonight for a movie? He said, no, I have to go and play soccer with my friends. He said, no, leave the friends, come watch movie with me. He said, no, I have to go and play soccer with you. Okay, fine. In the night, he went to play soccer. While he's coming out, he get into his car. While he's going, he got an accident. And he died. So the one who was driving, he was sleeping in the house, he got the message, so-and-so died, and they will put him into the, you know, graveyard at so-and-so time. So he was shocked, like, you know, just in the morning he was with me, and of course, those who went through this, it's kind of hard to believe, you know, a person was with me in the morning, what happened to him? So they show that, you know, the friend is sitting in the graveyard crying and thinking about, you know, when he was walking with him and etc., etc. After that, he sat in the car, he closed the door, his own car. He was thinking about him, so he saw the papers that he kept. So he saw the paper, he took the paper and he flipped it. It was checklist, finishing Quran 5 times, calling all my family members in Ramadan, doing i'tikaf in the last 10 days, giving charity every day, whole his list. And he died, and this is a real story, and he died before Ramadan 4 days. So subhanAllah, look at this paper that he made his checklist that I would like to do this and this and this. Inshallah, it will be rewarded for him. You know? So we have to keep this kind of intention of ibadah all the time in our heart. We never know when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calls us.
Exactly. Jazakallah.